Hello everyone, welcome back to my Pipedrive tutorial series where I show you how to set up Pipedrive the right way and how to use it efficiently so that your team is more productive. In this video, we are going to cover how to automatically add new inquiries to your Pipedrive account. Now you can use many different automation tools to do this, and some of these tools are Zapier, Make, which was formerly known as Integromat. There is also Eniten, there is Pipedream, and there are many such several automation tools. For this video, I'm going to use Make, which is also known as Integromat, to show you how you can add inquiries to your Pipedrive account. I'm going to add links to these tools in the video description below. Some of these links will be affiliate links, which means if you decide to sign up using the links that I have provided, and if you decide to become a paid customer of those platforms will share affiliate commissions with me at no additional cost to you. So now let's jump into how this is set up inside Make for my account. Now, the source of the inquiry for my account in this case is a Calendly booking page. Now, the moment somebody books a new meeting with me on my Calendly account, I will search if a person already exists in my Pipedrive account with that particular email address. If they do, which means it will take this particular route. If the person is present, in this case, what I'll do is I'll just create a deal with that particular person and add it to my pipeline in the meeting booked stage. What I'll also do is I'll add the note. There appears to be some problem with this particular step, but we can quickly update it now live on the call. Let's see if it worked. Okay, it didn't. Let me copy and paste. Oops, it's the same issue here. Now this is a good thing. Now you can see how to, you will see how to use Integromat as well. So in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to simply add questions and answers. And for my Pipedrive account, I have questions, so I'll have two sets of questions and answers. So this will be zero, this will be zero, and I'll add the placeholders for one. I'm going to copy this, I'm going to associate it with the deal ID, the person ID. I don't use organization, so that's fine. Created at pinned, yes, pinned to organization, no, pinned to person, no. Done. And now I'm going to simply follow the same steps here. Deal ID, the person ID is going to be the person ID from the search step, the created at pin, no, no. I'm going to click OK. I'm going to auto align this. So now cool. So coming back to how this was set up. So if I find a person inside Pipedrive with the same email address, what I'm going to do is I'm only going to create a new deal associated with that particular person. And then, sorry, ignore this. And then I'm also going to assign or pass the questions that the person answered while booking that meeting with me and add that as a pinned note to my deal and person. Now, if the person did not exist inside Pipedrive, what I'll do is I'll first create a person record, assign it to myself, then follow the same steps. Now I'll create the deal assigned to the newly created person, and then assign a note, create a note that is assigned to the deal and the person. So this is how it is set up. I'm going to quickly save this, and now we are going to jump to the live demo of how this works. So this is my paid priority discovery call. I'm going to select the free option now because I don't want to transact online while doing this demo video. So I'm now on the free discovery call page. I'm going to pick a date on the 27th, 10 p.m. confirm with Sarda. This is my own email address. It's completely fine. I need help with setting up Pipedrive. Can you help? Can you also show me how to use in the right way. Cool. And I'm going to add my number. Now the moment I click schedule event, let's see what happens. Schedule event confirmed. Now here is the newly created deal. Let's see. Great. Okay, this is not the one that was recently created. This is the one that was recently created. Yeah. So now, as you can see, a person with name Amit Sarda was created. A deal was created with this particular person. And then also a pinned note was created for this particular person. Let's do another demo. In this case, let me book free glide click kickoff, which has more questions, right? In this case, I'll select the 27th, no slots available on the 27th, 28th. This is going to be Amit G. Sarda. I'll use my business email, YZ. I need to develop an app using Glide apps. Can you help? I will share the requirements shortly. Cool. I understand that I should I decide to work with you, it will be a paid engagement. Yes. Again, the same phone number. Now, because I'm using a separate email address, this is going to create a separate person record. So I'm clicking on schedule event. Now, when I come back to Pipedrive, the person record should be here. Let me quickly check what happened. One record, show queue. Why did it error? Let's see. Okay, create a person. Array of object. Let's pass this information the right way. Let's edit this. It's a good thing we are running into these issues while trying to address this topic. So I remember setting this up the right way. For some weird reason, this has not worked. Phone number, primary, yes, primary, yes, and done. I'm going to quickly save this and I'm going to click on run once. It is going to ask me if I want to process existing requests. I'm going to say yes. And this time it has gone through. So now coming back to Pipedrive, this is what we have. This is the one that was erroneously created, but this is what we are interested in. So now I'm coming back to Pipedrive. It has created a separate new record for Amit G. Sarda with my business email, with my phone number. It has created a deal and it has also created a pin note that describes the requirements. So cool. In this video, I've shown you how to set up an automation to send your leads to Pipedrive from any source. All that is required is that source to have an integration with Make, which is Integromat or Zapier. And then you can replace this first step and replicate the rest of these steps for any different source that you have. I'm going to switch this on so that any new inquiry will now flow into my Pipedrive account very fluently. So if you have any questions about automations or about Zapier or Integromat or Pipedrive, feel free to comment below or reach out to me on my website. I'll add links to all these resources in the video description below. And if there are any other topics that you would like me to cover in the coming days that are related to Pipedrive, please let me know and I'll be happy to include them in this video series on Pipedrive that I'm doing. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.